In this video, we're talking about some special chemical reactions that produce gas when they occur, that gas is one of the products. So first thing is, here they are, and this you just have to memorize. This is not something that you're gonna figure out from stuff we've talked about so far. You just have to remember that when you're doing a double replacement reaction, so you know, you're doing it on paper and you're figuring out what the products would be. If you do a double replacement reaction and you see carbonic acid as one of the products, H2CO3, you just have to know that it will spontaneously decompose to make carbon dioxide gas and liquid water. Likewise, sulfurous acid will spontaneously decompose to make sulfur dioxide gas and water. And ammonium hydroxide will decompose to make ammonia gas and water. And you have to recognize these, so memorize this. Let me illustrate why that's going to be important. So let's say you're reacting sodium carbonate with hydrochloric acid, and you want to figure out what the overall equation is going to be. Well, you recognize this as a double replacement reaction, sodium carbonate and hydrochloric acid. So you switch the cations, right? Hydrogen ion replaces sodium to make carbonic acid. Carbonic acid. And the sodium ion replaces the hydrogen ion to make sodium chloride, where I've balanced the charges to get the subscripts and balanced the equation with the coefficients, the 2 and the 2 here. But, and you just have to recognize this by memorizing the previous slide, that when you see this carbonic acid, you have to remember that it decomposes. And when it does, it makes carbon dioxide gas and water. So when the overall reaction that we see, it's going to be the net result of these two. And what you do, okay, to get the overall reaction is you just add these two equations. Now, when you add chemical equations, it's just like adding algebraic equations. If you have the x on the left side of an equal sign in one equation and an x on the right side of the equal sign in another equation, and you're adding them together, the x's cancel, right? Well, here we have carbonic acid on the right-hand side of the arrow in one equation that we're adding, and carbonic acid on the left-hand side of the arrow on the other equation that we're adding, and they cancel. And so everything else that's left is our overall equation. So on the left side of the arrow, we have sodium carbonate reacting with hydrochloric acid to make sodium chloride from here, carbon dioxide gas, and liquid water. And so what you see when you add hydrochloric acid to sodium carbonate is you see bubbles. The bubbles are the carbon dioxide gas evolving. Let's look at another example. Let's say you're reacting solid strontium hydroxide and solid ammonium chloride. This is a really interesting reaction because two solid ionic compounds react with each other. And it's a double replacement reaction. And so if you take the ammonium ion, which is the cation here, right, NH4+, and replace strontium over here, you get ammonium hydroxide. Or if you balance the charges, each hydroxide has a negative one. The ammonium has a plus one, so we just get NH4OH, right? And when the strontium replaces the ammonium, we get strontium chloride, two chlorines to balance the positive 2 charge on the strontium. But, again, yeah, just have to recognize this, ammonium hydroxide is one of those compounds, the special ones that will decompose spontaneously like this. The ammonium hydroxide makes ammonia and water. Now, I've put the 2 in front here because we had the 2 here, and I want to add these equations again. And so when we add them, again, the 2 ammonium hydroxides cancel on each side, and our overall equation, what we observe is this. The strontium hydroxide reacts with ammonium chloride to make strontium chloride and ammonia gas and water. So when you do this reaction, what you see is you mix two white powders basically together, swirl them together, and if you smell it, you'll smell really kind of a harsh odor. That's the ammonia gas being given off. And it'll also become a slurry. That's because the water is being formed.